real priest, but now I'm a church bureaucrat, which in the preaching business is kind of like the water boy when they run out of everybody else on the team and throw the water boy in. So his one of the boys got potentially exposed to some COVID at school, and he thought it would be the wisest course not to expose y'all if he wasn't exposed to his son. So the water boy's here. We'll get through it. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. There is one body and one spirit.
One
Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God, Father of all.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Blessed Lord, who caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning, grant us so to hear them, read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that we may embrace and ever hold fast the blessed hope of everlasting life with which you have given us in our Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the reading of God's Word.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Be silent before the Lord God, for the day of the Lord is at hand. The Lord has prepared a sacrifice. He has consecrated his guest. At that time, I will search Jerusalem with lamps. I will punish the people who rest complacently on their dregs, those who say in their hearts, the Lord will not do good, nor will he do harm. Their wealth shall be plundered, and their houses laid waste. Though they build houses, they shall not inhabit them. Though they plant vineyards, they shall not drink wine from them. The great day of the Lord is near, near and hastening fast. The sound of the day of the Lord is bitter. Warriors cried aloud there. That day will be the day of wrath, a day of distress and anguish, a day of ruin and devastation, a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and thick darkness, a day of trumpet blast and battle cry against the fortified cities and against the lofty battlements. I will bring such distress upon people that they shall walk like the blind because they have sinned against the Lord. Their blood shall be poured out like dust, and their flesh like dung. Neither the silver nor the gold will be able to save them on the day of the Lord's wrath. In the fire of his passion, a whole earth shall be consumed, a full, a terrible end. He will make all of the inhabitants of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Because of your wrathful anger. yet the sum of them is but labor and sorrow, for they pass away quickly and we are gone. Who regards the power of your wrath? Who rightly fears your indignation? So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom.
A reading from Paul's first letter to the church in Thessalonica. Now concerning the times and the seasons, brothers and sisters, you do not need to have anything written to you, for you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. When they say there is peace and security, then sudden destruction will come upon them, as labor pains come upon a pregnant woman, and there will be no escape. But you, beloved, are not in darkness, for that day to surprise you like a thief, for you are all children of light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. So then let us not fall asleep as others do, but let us keep awake and be sober. For those who sleep, sleep at night, and those who are drunk, get drunk at night. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober and put on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. For God has destined us not for wrath, but for obtaining salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, so that whether we are awake or asleep, we may live with him. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up, as indeed you are doing. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
quite as peripatetic as Aaron, but my name is Allison DeFore. I'm the canon to the ordinary. I'm not a stranger to this parish, and I've been here quite a bit over the years, and I live about 15 minutes north of here, so it's a pleasure to be with you again. Jesus today talks about, it's a gospel that can come across as very harsh at first glance until you understand what he's doing. He's trying to get our attention. By this phase of his ministry, he realized that he had a bunch of dopes for disciples. These people were just not getting it. Kind of like a lot of days, I don't get it. I'm kind of standing in for them at this point in disciples. And he's trying to get their attention by speaking very graphically to them. Those of us who are Southerners kind of know how that works. I had a very good friend from right here in Orange Park for many years, Tom Slade, a sinner if ever there was one, and he, and a child of God, and he used to say, there ain't no lesson in the second kick of a mule. Now, I don't remember even what we were talking about, but I do remember the point of what he was saying, and I've never forgotten it. And that's what Jesus is trying to do here. Jesus is talking about our talents. The talent word in Latin has to do, it comes down to us as talents, which we think of not as money today. We think of it as like you have a talent for something. But the truth is, if you have a talent for it, you probably also have put in an awful lot of work to hone that talent, because what do they say? It's 10,000 hours to really get to mastery of something, 10,000 hours of repetition and practice. And but that's where the word comes from. In Jesus' time, it was a unit of money. And a talent was 15 years worth of a laborer's labor. So we're talking about a bunch of money here. Jesus is really overstating his point to make it. 15 years times 5 is 75. We're talking about essentially a lifetime to the first person. He gives him a fortune. To the second person, two 15-year laborers' wages, which would be a career, certainly at the very least. And to the last one, he gives one talent. The two go off and invest it and risk. They do what you're supposed to do with what God gives you. I, for instance, ran from my call for many, 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 many years. I rose up the ladder, but I had it on the wrong wall, and was in a board meeting of a seminary in Miami and had been on the board at Sewanee and heard a voice clear as a bell say, this is the second seminary I put you on the board of. When are you going to get the point and be a student, not a trustee? And I said, well, I won't say what I said, but I said, uh-oh, a version of uh-oh. And because I realized my whole life was going to change, and it did. And another thing changed. I got peace because I was in God's lane. And that's what we have to do with the talent that God has put in us. We aren't to do what the last person did, which is to go dig it a hole and bury it and try and hide it and hold on to it. Too much of what we do in church is that. We try and hold on to what oftentimes was given to us by our parents, as we're going to do today in a baptism. What's been inherited from our grandparents, the buildings. I'm convinced that when Jesus comes back, the first words he says when he gets here are going to be, real estate? Really? Did I say anything about real estate? Because they didn't. He didn't talk about real estate. He talked about our hearts. It's almost, one comparison I saw is that it's like somebody goes to the Amazon and they see all these incredible things and birds and parrots and dolphins and great river, and they come back and they say, let me tell you what I saw. Let me write it down. Let me give you a map. And then they go off to go back. And then we take the map and the description, and instead of taking the journey, we put it on the wall or we put it in a book. We read about it instead of taking the trip. We're called to venture out with the talents we've been given, to risk it all. And if we do that, God will reward us beyond our wildest imagination. When I finished my time as a prison priest, I said in my very last sermon, I had four little prison churches over in Tallahassee, non-stipendy area. It was really great. And I said, you know, it's hard for me to believe that I came in here 12 years ago, a lawyer politician who drank too much to save you. And we all started laughing. because the truth is they had saved me. But I had been willing to venture, to risk, to go out into the world is the secret of Christianity, of what we do in the faith. We have to give it away to keep it. And that's what we're going to do today with this baptism. We're going to do the down payment of a little bit of payment on what really is for us, because they're too little to fully know what they're getting into at this point, but they'll grow in the faith and we'll nurture them in the faith. We're going to take a pledge to that effect in just a minute. But that's how it works. By giving it to them, we get it back. And then they'll give it to their children. We'll all share and love each other, and because it's all ultimately about a love game, passing it around amongst ourselves. Amen. Let us stand and affirm our faith. Oops, no, wait a minute. No, it's not. The candidates for holy baptism will now be presented. All right, who makes the first presentation?
I present Ellie Mae Moore to receive the sacrament of baptism.
I present Nolan Mitchell Height to receive the sacrament.
Do you desire to be baptized? Yes. Let's see. Now, asking the parents and the godparents, will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is brought up in the Christian faith and life? Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ? We then ask the questions of the candidates who can speak for themselves, and this will be of the parents and godparents speaking on behalf of the infant children. Do you renounce Satan and all of the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God? Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God? Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God? Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept Him as your Savior? Do you put your whole trust in His grace and love? You promise to follow and obey Him as your Lord. Turning to the congregation, will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support these children in their lives in Christ? We will. Let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptism and our covenant. Do you believe in God the Father? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? In God the Holy Spirit. Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of the bread and in the prayers? Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord? Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ? Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself? Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being? Let us now pray for these children who are about to receive the sacrament of new birth, and for all of us who have renewed their commitments to Christ. Deliver them, O Lord, from the way of sin and death. Return their hearts to your grace and truth. Fill them with your holy and life-giving Spirit. Keep them in the faith and communion of your holy church. Teach them to love others in the power of the Spirit. Send them into the world to witness to your love. Bring them to the fullness of your peace and joy. Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation, and through it you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt and into the land of promise. In it your Son, Jesus, received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it we're buried with Christ in his death. By it we share in his resurrection. Through it we're reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into this fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who are here cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Amen. It's working. Chrism has been previously blessed by the bishop. Now, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit, you have bestowed upon your servants the forgiveness of sin and have raised them to the new life of grace. Sustain them, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give them an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your work. receive you into the household of God. Confess the faith of Christ. Proclaim his resurrection and share with us in his eternal priesthood. Let us welcome the newly baptized. Welcome. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We didn't do a lot of that in prison, so thank you. That was a privilege. We will now have the prayers of the people.
The prayers of the people can be found on page 359 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray for the Universal Church, its members, and its mission. Let us pray for the nation and all in authority. Let us pray for the welfare of the world. Let us pray for the concerns of the local community. Let us pray for those who suffer and those in any trouble. Let us pray for the departed. Let us especially pray for our own needs and those of others, especially Jean, John, Robert, Ken, Vita and Barry, Jim, Linda, Chris, Stephen, Ivy, Kelly, Darren, Bree, Charlie, Kenneth, Chip, Barbara, Paul, Bernie, Brenda, Dee Dee, John, Nancy L, Nancy Y, Kimberly, our parish school and its students and faculty, and for all those that we may know who have not been called at this time. Amen.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. Glory. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all of your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Amen. offer to God a sacrifice of thanksgiving and make good your vows to the Most High. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, for you are the source of light and life. You made us in your image and called us to a new life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, in all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. In your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. The night he was handed over to suffering and death, Our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. When he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. The holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all of your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All of this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we're bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Hallelujah! Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us receive the feast. Hallelujah!
These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ